tower in San Andres Bukid. It's a small neighborhood in the city of Manila. So on a map, it would be very, very small. But if you look at the statistics, it has the second highest population density in relation to its small size. So there's a lot of social problems here. It's very overpopulated, so there's a very big scarcity of resources, which means families and children have to compete to get what they need, actually, to survive. So Project Bantu was actually founded by our master, Mestre Hoshinu, who founded the project in 1998 in Brazil. It takes from his own experiences growing up in poverty, and he started that in 1998, and about 7 years ago, we started doing the same thing in 2012. When we think about Filipino children, especially children from neighborhoods like this, they have a lot of deficits or disadvantages that really start from an early age. It can be very difficult for them to adjust to certain situations, and things like school, things like the workplace, things that many other kids would take for granted and find to be very easy because they've been so accustomed to it their entire lives. Kids from here have a real challenge adjusting to it. So why is capoeira a good activity for them? Capoeira is a great activity because it combines a lot of dynamic elements. It combines music, movements, mock combat game. There's a lot of playing, there's a lot of dialogue. You know, and capoeira really introduces them into this environment where there are a lot of rules, a lot of structures. And it really starts by engaging them. And through what we do, through regular classes, we help them understand why rules and structures are important, are necessary, and can actually lead to them learning and growing as young adults.
Yung pinaka gusto ko, itong ano, yung pagkanta, yung paggawa namin ng movements, mas yung pagkakasabay-sabay namin. Itulong niya yung pagtulong sa school supplies namin, kasi yung mga pambili ng gamot, project, iba pa.
Ano, gusto ko kasi, tumagal sa kapwera, magturo na magturo, kasi doon ako nagiging masaya sa kapwera.
One thing that we would really like to make clear to people is that capoeira is the vehicle that we use, but that what we are actually doing is trying to achieve behavioral transformation in these children. I tell this to the kids, you know, this isn't about you learning how to do kicks or flips or tumbles or, you know, playing instruments or singing well, but this is more about you finding out how you're going to learn all of these things, mustering the discipline and the grit and the persistence. And in that process, how you can relate all of these things to your life as a young person, as a student, as a member of your family, as a member of your community. And so through the activities, through the music, through the movements, we use those things as kind of the delivery system to get the message across. This has really become a life's work kind of thing for me, where we try to empower these young people and give them control over their own destinies and help them realize that, you know, if you are able to develop discipline and can control yourself through your thoughts and things like that, then the possibilities are just as limitless as for kids who have all the resources. So I guess that's why it matters. It would be really foolish of us not to invest in young people. I would like to tell all other Filipinos, there's always something we can do to make something a little bit better. And so why not do it in a place where there's a lot of need?